Welcome back students to e-learning platform Gyanmantri Vidyapeeth online education. Students, in this unit, the name of this unit is Ranga's Marriage, and in this lesson we are going to study the story of Ranga. In previous video lecture we discussed that in actually the town, in that village, there is no people, there is no one who knows the language English well, and that's why actually people are interested in such kind of person like Ranga. Ranga is the only person in the village who knows the English language well, and that's why anytime they find the kind of things, the help for the English language, they always take help of Ranga. And now Ranga has come. People could come to know that there was the person named Ranga in the village, and for the further education, for this purpose, he had gone outside from the village. Now he has come back, and that's why they all gathered at the same place. They all went to the house of Ranga and welcomed him and cheered up in the great manner. So now students, we are going to proceed further in this lesson. You may keep your supplementary reader with you. Okay, so the first line, the next paragraph, actually I must draw your attention to this aspect of Ranga's character. Now something different is there about Ranga's character. What is that? He knew when it would be to his advantage to talk to someone and rightly assess people's worth. As for his namaskara to me, he did not do it like any present day boy. Actually, behind any kind of things, behind any kind of activities, there is strong reason. The strong reason Ranga has for everything. The things, the activities, and even the regards also, suppose he makes, then also he has the strong motives. So here it is said, as for his namaskara to me, he did not do it like any present day boy. It means right nowadays boys do not do the same thing that Ranga actually did. That is something different. With his head up towards the sun, standing stiff like a pole without joints, jerking his body as if it was either a wand or a walking stick, nor did he merely fold his hands. He bent low to touch my feet. May you get married soon, I said, blessing him. After exchanging a few pleasantries, I left. Here the statements actually mention the kind of good qualities and virtuous natures of Ranga. That actually nowadays boys also do not have this kind of qualities sometimes, virtues, but Ranga actually has. And to get blessings, he tried to touch the feet of this man, and he gave the blessings also. And what is the blessing? See, may you get married soon. This is the blessing given by the person to Ranga. Next paragraph, students. That afternoon when I was resting, Ranga came to my house with a couple of oranges in his hand. Now, it was the first meeting, and now the second time they are going to visit each other. They are going to meet each other. That afternoon when I was resting, Ranga came to my house with a couple of oranges in his hand. With oranges he came. A generous, considerate fellow. It would be a fine thing to have him marry, settle down and be of service to society, I thought. Actually, here the writer thinks that Ranga should get married now. It is the proper time that he can get married, and it would be very greater thing. Suppose he also can help him to get married, because he is now going to be the proper fellow who is actually eligible bachelor for the marriage, and after marriage he can serve the society in a better manner, and he can serve the nation in a better manner. That's why this uncle, the writer, wishes that Ranga should get married now. It is the time. Okay, now the next paragraph. For a while, we talked about these and that. Means something blah blah blah. They talk about some various topics, these and that, like that. Then I came to the point. Rangappa, when do you plan to get married? Means what's your plan about the marriage? The writer asked this question to Ranga. I'm not going to get married now, he said. Why not? Actually, Ranga replied, when it was an answer, it was a question asked to Ranga that when are you going to get married? And Ranga simply replies that I'm not going to get married right now. Why not? Again, the next question is asked by the writer. Next paragraph, students. I need to find the right girl. Actually, there is not proper, there is not right girl that actually I want to get married. That's why. I know an officer who got married only 6 months ago. He's about 30 and his wife is 25. I am told, means the writer is told, he is informed that I actually know one officer is there and the age of this officer is 30 years and the age of that girl to whom he has got married, the age of that girl is 25. They will be able to talk lovingly to each other. Let's say I married a very young girl. It means Ranga is thinking that this, in this sense, we can say that he is thinking about mature person. See, he's saying that the age of the boy is, that man is 30 years and the age of that girl, that woman is 25 years old, and that's why they both are able to understand each other, to know in a better way, and that's why they will be able to talk in a loving manner. So actually writer now wants to say that let me say that I got married in a very younger age and even a younger girl. She may take my words spoken in love as words spoken in anger. She may take my words spoken in love as words spoken in anger. It means she can understand all those things. She may take all the words as anger also and as love also. So every time it's not about maturity. Recently, a troupe in Bangalore staged the play Shakuntala. We know, students, that it is very well-known play, Shakuntala, okay? In the history also, it has been mentioned about this play, Shakuntala. It has been written by Kalidas, very well-known person. There is no question of Dushyanta falling in love with Shakuntala if she were young, like the present-day brides. Is there, it means... there is no possibility for falling in love for Dushyanta if Shakuntala is not matured enough. If she is that much too young, like right nowadays, like brides, then there is not that much possibility for falling in love. That is said here. It shows actually the mentality, the attitude of this person, Ranga. Ranga's mentality, Ranga's attitude, he's thinking about the marriage. Is that what would have happened to Kalidas play if one gets married? It should be to a girl who is mature. This is the thinking of right now Ranga, that what happened with Kalidas. A person should be married, a person should marry with only the girl who is mature enough to understand everything. Not with a very much young girl who cannot even understand anything well. Otherwise, one should remain a bachelor. That's why I am not marrying now. If there is no mature girl, if not any person who can understand everything well, then a person should remain bachelor. And that's why right now Ranga does not want to marry. That's why he has decided that actually he is not interested to get married right now. Okay, students, now let's see the next. Okay, now the writer asks, is there any other reason? A man should marry a girl he admires. Any other reasons are also there that you are not going to get married right now, or only this is the reason? Then Ranga replies, a man should marry a girl he admires, he likes, he praises, the kind of girl that actually he likes in the best way. What we have now are arranged marriage. What we have now are arranged marriage. This is our pattern in our society for marriage, that parents decide to whom the son, the daughter will get married according to the wish of parents. That is called arranged marriage. How can one admire a girl with milk stains on one side of her face and wetness on the other, or so young that she doesn't even know how to bite her fingers? It means here it is about very much young. Sometimes we can say that it is not quite young also. That much it is said little, that how can a person get married with a girl who even doesn't know how to eat, who even doesn't know how to behave properly. There is milk the one side and wetness the other side. So no kind of sense of behaving or doing or even eating. So that is not the maturity. So a person should marry with a mature girl. The next statement, one a neem fruit, the other a bitter gourd. With neem also and with bitter gourd also, actually both the things, whatever you want to pluck, whatever you want to choose, ultimately there will be bitterness in your taste, with your taste. So it is said here. Exactly, Ranga said, laughing. I was distressed that the boy who I thought would make a good husband had decided to remain a bachelor. Actually, the writer thinks that he was actually thinking, he was quite sure even, that Ranga can become, he can be proved as a good husband. And in the paradox, Ranga has decided not to get even married. That's why it is a little bit strange also. After chatting for a little longer, Ranga left. I made up my mind right then that I would get him married. Now the writer has decided, he has decided that he will make him married. He is that much interested for the marriage of Ranga. That's why he decides that he will make the marriage and he will set down something for Ranga. Next paragraph, students. Rama Rao's niece, a pretty girl of 11, had come to stay with him. Now the another character here arrives, enters to this story. And who is this character? See, Rama Rao's niece, a pretty girl of 11. The age of this girl is 11 years old, had come to stay with him. Him meant to stay with Ranga, as at Ranga's house. She was from a big town, so she knew how to play the veena and the harmonium. She was knowing all these things, how to play and perform all these things. She also had a sweet voice. There is also a voice clarity with her. Her parents had died and her uncle had brought her home. Ranga was just a boy for her, and she the most suitable bride for him. Actually, the parents were died of this girl, and that's why her uncle had brought her to home. And Ranga was the kind of boy auntie for her, and that's why this pair is the most suitable for each other, and that's why this girl is the most suitable bride for him, for Ranga. Next paragraph, students. Since I was a frequent visitor to Rama Rao's place, the girl was quite free with me. Because the writer actually is very much habituated to visit the place where actually Ranga stays, and that's why it is said, the girl was quite free with me. I completely forgot to mention her name. What's the name of this girl? Ratna. Ratna is the name of this girl. Ratna it was. The very next morning, I went to their house and told Rama Rao's wife, I sent some buttermilk for you. Ask Ratna to fetch it. It means Ratna also knows very well that writer is very much familiar with this house, and Ratna also stays at the same place at the home. So here writer is saying that the next day I went to the place and I told that I will give some buttermilk, and that's why I called Ratna that she may collect all these things. Ratna came. It was Friday. So she was wearing a grand sari. Because it was Friday, that's why she was wearing a grand sari. I told her to sit in my room and requested her to sing a song. Because he knows that Ratna is very good at singing. Even she knows how to play harmonium. She even knows how to play veena. And that's why writer told him, rather he requested her that she should perform for the thing. I sent for Ranga while she was singing the song. I sent for Ranga while she was singing the song Krishnamurti in front of my eyes. It was a song. Ranga reached the door. He stopped at the their hut. He did not want the singing to stop, but was curious to see the singer. Carefully, he peeped in. The light coming into the room was blocked. Ratna looked up and seeing a stranger there, abruptly stopped. Actually, now she knows, now she can know very well that actually there is Ranga. Ranga actually right now, he does not know that who is there and who is singing actually all these things. And that's why the writer helped to meet both these people, and Ranga reached at the place where this girl is singing the song. He does not know who sings the song, but actually he does not want to stop this singing. And that's why he reached, and Ratna observed that there is a person who is observing her. Suppose you buy the best quality mango, you eat it slowly, savingly its peel, before biting into the juicy flesh. You do not want to waste any part of it. Before you take another bite, the fruit slips out of your hand and falls to the ground. How do you feel? Ranga's face showed the same disappointment when the singing stopped. Because actually Ranga was trying not to stop the singing, not to stop this voice. Here it is the example given by the writer about the mango. It is very fresh fruit and it is very much interesting in taste, very much tasty it is. You are just going to peel it and you will just taste it. The first portion you covered it, the second portion you are going to cover, you are going to eat, but before that it is not there in your hand. Okay, it is downside. So it is the same feeling that Ranga is feeling right now. The same kind of sentiment is here shown because of the singing has been stopped. That's why, because Ranga did not want to stop the singing, but it stopped. That's why. You sent for me, he asked as he came in and sat on a chair. Ratna stood at a distance, her head turned lowered. Ranga repeatedly glanced at her. Now he is observing her, he is looking at her. Once our eyes met and he looked very embarrassed. No one spoke for a long while. Ratna is there, Ranga is there, and writer is saying that now here Ranga feels very much embarrassed. He feels embarrassed that what is going on. Actually, he is very much confused. Even the girl is also very much confused. And nobody spoke for a long while. The writer is making the statement that nobody spoke for a long while. It was my coming in that stopped the singing. Let me live. Words, mere words. The fellow said he would leave but did not make a move. How can one expect words to match actions in these days of Kali Yuga? Actually, Ranga made the statement that because of me this happened, because of me this singing stopped, and that's why I should leave. But did not make a move. It means he even did not move. He said that he is going to leave, but actually he did not. The words are saying something different and the actions are also quite different. So here the funny statement has been made that in these kind of Kali Yuga, how one can expect that a person will be the kind of proper genuine speaking all the things truth only? Ratna ran inside, overcome by shyness. She felt shyness, that's why. After a while, Ranga asked, "Who's that girl?" "Swami." Now Ranga is something interested in, and that's why he asked that, "Who's that girl, Swami? Who's that inside?" The lion wanted to know. Who had taken shelter in the temple replied, "Does it matter who I am? I am a poor animal who has already eaten 9 lions. I have what to eat one more. Tell me, are you male or female?" The lion fled the place in fear, it seems. "Like the he got," I said, "what does it matter to either of us who she is? I'm already married and you aren't the marrying kind." It means actually Ranga wants to make a little bit inquiry about the girl, and that's why he asks about the girl, but writer somehow is not ready to explain all the things in a better way, and that's why he gives this example of this god, the lion and the animals, that she is maybe like a god that who has actually not here, and the kind of comparison has been made, and Ranga is also a little bit confused about all these things. "What does it matter to either of us who she is?" Means it doesn't matter that who is she, because I'm already married, so I'm not interested to know her, and you are not even going to get married, so you also should not take any kind of interest. Actually here the person, the writer, wants to create the interest in the mind of Ranga, but just wants to show that he is not interested and he is not making any kind of efforts, but actually that is not true. The writer is very much interested in this case, and the writer is trying to make the both the people meet, and that's why here the story takes different turn, rather we can say interesting turn. So I hope students that you could understand the things in today's lecture, but suppose you find any difficulty, any problem, you are free to ask me anytime. Okay students, take care of your health. Thank you. Have a nice day.